What's up, mathematicians? Welcome back to our lesson on the Pythagorean Theorem. In the last video, I showed you a proof for the Pythagorean Theorem. And in this video, I'll show you some examples and applications of situations where the Pythagorean Theorem shows up. For our first example, I'd like to go back to this situation from the previous lesson where we were measuring the lengths of the diagonal cross braces to support and stabilize that play structure. So let's take a look at that. Okay, so here is our solution from the previous video. We used the tangent function to find this angle, and then we used the sine function to find the length of the diagonal, the length of that cross brace. Now let's look at how we can use the Pythagorean theorem to find this length a little bit more quickly. So you see here, I have my square. Remember, it's a 32 by 32 square. So let's go ahead and write in those dimensions. So 32 inches by 32 inches. And of course, this right here is a right angle. All four of these angles around the square are right angles. And now we want to find this length right here. We'll call it x. Now, according to the Pythagorean theorem, the square of this leg plus the square of this leg is equal to the square of the hypotenuse, in this case, the diagonal of this square. And so we can set up the equation as follows. X squared is equal to 32 squared plus 32 squared. Now we're going to go ahead and pull out the calculator, and when you're doing these types of problems, you're probably going to be using the calculator pretty frequently. So have it close at hand. So let's go ahead and take 32 squared plus 32 squared, see what we get. We get 2048. So I'll write in the next step, x squared is equal to 2048. Now, in order to solve for x, we can take the square root of both sides. The square root of x squared is just x, and then let's use the calculator to find the square root of 2048. So here, square root 2048. I hit enter, and I get 45 1/4. So let's write that down. So 45.25 inches. Now we can go back to our previous paper and we see, sure enough, there it is, 45 1/4. So we got the same answer. And as you can see, this particular approach is a little bit quicker. Now, before we go on to the next example, I want to talk for just a moment about when you have a situation where you have a square and you want to find the diagonal, there is an approach that's even a little bit faster than what we did right here. So I'm just going to go ahead and draw. I'm going to draw this one freehand. So I'll go ahead and just draw a square quickly, and then I'll draw a diagonal through the square. Okay, just like this particular example above. But now I'm going to go ahead and say that these lengths are both 1, and let's figure out what this diagonal is. Now, according to the Pythagorean theorem, this diagonal, let's see, I'll just call it D. So the square of the diagonal is equal to 1 squared plus 1 squared. Well, 1 squared plus 1 squared is 1 plus 1, right? Because 1 squared is 1. And so this is 2. So the diagonal squared is equal to 2. And therefore, the diagonal, by taking the square root of both sides, we can see that the diagonal is equal to the square root of 2. So anytime you have a square, and if you know these two sides, then the length of the diagonal is going to be the square root of 2 times either of the sides. Like, think about this, right? This triangle here and this triangle here are similar. These are similar triangles. If we found these angles, these would both be, all these angles would be 45 degree angles. These are actually something called isosceles right triangles, meaning that these sides are equal, and then therefore those angles must also be equal. That's a theorem we will prove in unit number 3. So not the next unit, but the unit after. So the point is, anytime you have a square, you can just multiply the length of the side of the square by the square root of 2, and that will give you the diagonal of the square. So let's go ahead and just verify that here. So we have 32, and let's multiply it by the square root of 2. And I'll go ahead and do that in my on my calculator. So 32 times square root of 2. And once again, I can see that I get 45.25. So 45.25. Okay. I forgot to put a box around my answer up here. I'll go ahead and do that. So yeah, if you have a square and you want to find the diagonal of the square, just multiply the side of the square by the square root of 2, and it will give you the length of the diagonal. Okay, so now we're going to go on to the second example, and I'd actually like to show you a picture here before we get into it. So let's see, pull this up. Nope, sorry about that. Oh, there we go. So this is a photograph that I took at the Salt Lake Stadium in Kolkata in India. And this is, you know, a big stadium where soccer games are played. And what I thought we could do is we could find the length of the diagonal of the soccer field of this stadium in Kolkata. So let's see what that is. Okay, so I'll start with this rectangle, which will represent the soccer field at the Salt Lake Stadium. And we need to know the dimensions of this. We need to know some dimensions before we can find the diagonal. And I looked it up, and according to the internet, the length of the soccer field is 105 meters. And the width here of the soccer field is 68 meters. This is a fairly standard size for a soccer field. It's actually the same size as like the one in Barcelona, the Club Nou field where the Barcelona Football Club plays, and many other soccer fields as well have dimensions equal to or very close to this. And so now that we see the length and the width of the field, we're going to use the Pythagorean theorem. Let me go ahead and draw on this diagonal here. Let's use the Pythagorean theorem to find the length from one corner to an opposite corner of the field. We'll go ahead and call this x. So according to the Pythagorean theorem, we know that, well, since x is the hypotenuse, here's my right angle, x squared is equal to 105 squared plus 68 squared. Pretty simple, right? And once again, we will use the calculator to do this computation right here. You could do it by hand, but you know, it would take a while. So let's plug it in the calculator. So 105 squared plus 68 squared, and that gives me 15,649. So x squared equals 15,649. So to get that value of x, actually I'll just keep this right here because I'm going to need it again. I take the square root of both sides and I get that x is equal to, let's see, second square root, 15,649. I hit enter and I get 125.1 meters if I round to the nearest tenth of a meter. So we'll say 125.1 meters. So that is the diagonal length of this soccer field. Now, we can't use that trick that I, you know, showed you in the last example where you can multiply by something like the square root of 2. This only works when you're dealing with a square, and there's not a similar thing with a rectangle because, you know, if it's a longer rectangle versus a more squarish rectangle, yeah, there's no consistent number. So you just have to go ahead, go through the Pythagorean theorem. But as you can see, it actually goes pretty quickly. So that's our second example. Let's move on to example number 3. Okay, for the third example, I want to share with you an example that comes from my own personal life experience. And it actually involves this bookshelf that you see right behind me here. Now, this bookshelf, I actually found this in front of a neighbor's house. It was, you know, just out by the street, and I saw it. I was like, wow, that looks like a pretty cool bookshelf. I'd love to have it as like a backdrop for these math videos that I want to make, which you're watching right now. And so I was pretty excited to see that bookshelf. I was like, what a great place to put all my nice math books and other books that I have here. So I took it home, and I didn't really have the room set up to put it up yet, so I put it in a different room. And once I got the room set up, I wanted to move it from that room to this room. And so the thing is about the way it's secured, if I were to tip it sort of flat on its side, it maybe wouldn't be super stable. And so I wanted to see if I could tip it, like from the orientation it's in right now, the proper one, if I could rotate it like this and then carry it, you know, because just sliding it was actually too tall to fit under the doorway. So I thought, well, I'll rotate it like this and see if I can slide it or carry it with my wife and into this room. But the thing I had to figure out is this. When I rotate it, will the top corner, like will the corner of the bookshelf hit the ceiling? Like, is the ceiling tall enough for me to rotate this bookshelf on its side? And so I measured the height and the width of the bookshelf, and I used the Pythagorean theorem to answer that question. So let's look at how I did that right here. Okay, so this rectangle right here, it represents the bookshelf. You know, we can put, well, no, actually I'm not going to draw shelves on it because I don't want to clutter up the space. So the dimensions of the bookshelf are as follows. The width of it is 54 inches. So it's a 54 inch width. And then the height of the bookshelf is 82 inches. And I need to find this diagonal length because if I were to tip it, you know, rotate it to tip it on its side, this length here would have to be less than the height of the ceiling to make sure I didn't hit the ceiling in that process. So let's go ahead and draw in that line, that diagonal. All right. And of course, you know, this bookshelf is pretty well constructed, so these are right angles. This is a right angle right here. So you can see we have a right triangle, which of course, it's always important to remember, in order to use the Pythagorean theorem, you need to have a right triangle. So we have a right triangle, and I want to know what this length is right here. Another piece of information that is relevant to the problem is the ceiling height, okay? So the ceiling height is 8 feet or 96 inch. So this is the height that I need to make sure is greater than this length in order to rotate that bookshelf. Okay, so let's go ahead and use the Pythagorean theorem. So we get x squared is equal to 54 squared plus 82 squared. And let's plug that in the calculator right here. So 54 squared plus 82 squared, that gives me 9,640. So x squared equals 9,640. Now I take the square root of both sides to get x. So second square root. And by the way, one way to recall a number, if you don't want to type it in again, you hit second and then you see answer above the zero if you're using this type of calculator. And that will recall that 9,640. Hit enter. And I get a little more than 98 inches. So 98.2 inches rounded to the nearest tenth of an inch. Well, what does that mean? Since the height of the ceiling is 96 inches and the diagonal of the bookshelf is 98.2 inches, that means that I cannot rotate this bookshelf the way I want to, put it on its side, carry it through the door. So what did I end up doing? I in fact ended up partially disassembling it. There's sort of a top half and a bottom half that can come apart. So I did partially disassemble it into two pieces to move it into the room and reassemble it. And I knew that I had to do that because I used the Pythagorean theorem to find out that diagonal height. Okay, so all the applications that I've shown you so far have involved squares or rectangles, but I'm going to show you two more applications before we finish this video that involve triangles. And the first one is a classic ladder problem. These show up all the time when you know you are doing Pythagorean theorem application problems in you know the SAT, ACT, that type of thing. These ladder problems are popular. They show up in textbooks and such. So I thought, you know what, let's do one of those ladder problems. Why not? And so I went on to Home Depot and I thought, okay, what's the length of a typical ladder? And this ladder shows up on the Home Depot website as a 24-foot ladder. And but then when I looked at the actual dimensions of it, it turns out, I don't know if you can read this, but the maximum height of the ladder is 21 feet. So what's up with that, Home Depot? You're advertising a 24-foot ladder that has a maximum height of 21 feet? I don't know. That seems a bit misleading to me. But anyway, all right, we'll go with that. This ladder has a maximum height of 21 feet. And so let's set up a problem that could involve this ladder right here. So here is my setup. And we're going to say that the ladder is on flat ground and it's leaning up against a wall taller than whatever this 21 feet whatever this distance right here. So the length of the ladder as specified is 21 feet, and then we will say that the distance from the wall to the base of the ladder, let's go ahead and imagine that that distance is 5 feet. And then the question is, how high up the wall can this ladder reach? Okay, so this is a right angle. I'm going to say this wall is well constructed, perpendicular to the ground. And so this is our x. Okay, so if you look at this situation, you'll realize that we will not have x by itself on one side of the equation, because the hypotenuse, 21 feet, is known. But let's go ahead and set up this problem and use the Pythagorean theorem to solve it. So here we go. So on one side, we're going to have 21 squared. That's the hypotenuse. And the square of the hypotenuse is equal to the sum of the squares of the two legs. So that will be x squared for this distance here, plus 5 squared for this distance here. All right. Well, 21 squared is 441, I believe. I hope I'm remembering that correctly. I can check it in the calculator momentarily. But that is equal to x squared plus 25, which is 5 squared. Now we will subtract 25 from both sides. Minus 25. Okay, and so let's see, 441 minus 25 will be 416, and that is equal to x squared. Okay, now in order to get x by itself, I take the square root of both sides, and we get that x is equal to, this one I definitely will plug in the calculator. Let's double check to make sure I did that other one right. 21 squared, 441. Cool. Okay, so then square root of 416 is 20.4. We'll round to the nearest foot. So 20.4 feet. So how high up the wall will the ladder reach? It will reach 20.4 feet up the wall. Okay, so before we wrap up the video, I want to show you just one more example. This one is, not as much an application based on a real world situation. I'm just going to look at an isosceles triangle where I know the base and the slant height, and we're going to find the height. Now, of course, this could apply to many real world situations, but we're going to just sort of keep it in the abstract for this particular problem. So looking at this isosceles triangle, we're going to say this is an isosceles triangle, meaning that these two sides are equal. And this length, which is sometimes referred to as the slant height, we'll call that length 20. And then we'll say the length of the base of this triangle is 12. Now the height is going to be at a right angle. And since this is 12, well, this is going to divide this into two equal parts. And so that means this part right here is 6. So before you solve this problem, you do have to make sure you divide this 12 in half to get that this length is 6. And now we want to find the height of this isosceles triangle. That length we will call x, and that's what we'll solve for. So once again, like the last example, we won't have the x squared by itself. And so we'll have to do a little bit algebraic manipulation, not too much, nothing too bad. But we have the hypotenuse is 20. So we have 20 squared is equal to, well, one of the legs is 6. So we'll say 6 squared plus the other leg, which is the height, is x. So we say x squared. So let's see, 20 squared is 400. 6 squared is 36. And we have x squared over here. So in order to solve for x, we're going to subtract both sides by 36. And 36 minus 36, of course, is 0. So those cancel out. And 400 minus 36 would be 364. Okay, so, and that is equal to x squared. Now to find the value of x, I just take the square root of both sides, and let's plug that in the calculator here. So let's see, the square root of 364, hit enter, I'm gonna get 19.1 rounded to the nearest tenth. So x is equal to 19.1. So that is the height of this isosceles triangle, 19.1 units, whatever units you're working in. Okay, so that's the last example that I'm going to show you in this video. Okay, so that wraps up our lesson on the Pythagorean theorem. In the next lesson, we're going to move beyond measuring length to measuring area. So something to look forward to there. As always, thank you so much for watching. If you learned something here, please do consider hitting that like and subscribing. And thank you, and we'll see you in the next lesson. Bye-bye.